My topic is how forensic odontology can help in the sex determination in forensic science. And next slide, sir, please. Next slide, sir.
Okay, next slide.
Yes. So dental identification plays important role when identification of the remains of the diseased person is like skeletonized, decomposed, any burnt or which body, when body is invalid for the visual or the fingerprint method, that time we can use the dental identification. So the forensic dentistry is the branch where it deals with the proper handling and examination of dental evidence and the proper evaluation and presentation of dental findings. The remnants of the body can be traced by teeth size, morphology, facial and cranial bones, processes, the DNA of the victims using samples from the various sources such as teeth and oral epithelium. The methods which we use for the sex determination in forensic odontology is, we can go by the tooth size, tooth morphology, canine dimorphism, dental index, like and other like soft tissue analysis like rugoscopy and kelioscopy, molecular analysis like bar bodies, F bodies, enamel proteins, and sometimes labeled processes can be used, and even orthometric methods can help, like a skull, mandible, frontal sinus dimensions, maxillary sinus dimensions can help. Next.
Bhumika, you have the
next slide, sir.
I think you have the low bandwidth, so I request you can turn off the camera and do your presentation if possible.
Okay, sir. Yes. Okay. And the other method which we can use is in tooth morphology. The slide on tooth morphology, sir.
We are on the same slide.
In tooth morphology, we can use the
can any other participant can confirm?
In teeth tooth morphology, we can use the measurement like distance of the bone.
Bhumika, I think we have a very disturbing connection at your end. If the chairperson and other jury member can hear her voice, any jury member can confirm?
No, no, we can't.
No, we cannot hear.
We can't hear.
So I think no, Bhumika, you have a low bandwidth connection. So what should I do, sir, Sunil, sir?
I think you can just wait for, we can go for the next two presenters, and till that we will see at the end, we will try for again Bhumika.
Yeah, Bhumika, you can try again because you have a low bandwidth connection. So I think...
I changed my Wi-Fi, sir. Now it is audible, sir?
Yeah, perfect. Please go ahead.
Okay. So in tooth morphology, we can use the teeth dimensions like mesodistal dimension and buccolingual dimensions, which is significantly different in male and female patients, and even in the deciduous and permanent teeth, which is it is different. And crown dimensions and the root length, we can almost get the 80% of accuracy for the gender sex determination. And mainly mandibular canines are used. It is used as a key tool for the sex determination. Their mesodistal width and the incisor cervical height can be used, which is greater in the males than the females. It is almost 6 in the males, 6 millimeters, and 6.5 millimeters in females and 6.5 millimeters in male minimum, and maximum it could be 7 to 7.5 millimeters. So it can be used as a key tool. Next slide, sir. Next slide, yes. And in orthometric method, they have used skulls, and other than skulls, we can use the mandible, supraorbital ridge, mastoid, nasal process, even the frontal sinus diameters. We can use for the gender determination, and it almost gives 94% of the accuracy in the gender determination. And in soft tissue analysis, we can go do rugoscopy and kelioscopy. In rugoscopy, because palatal rugae is different for every each and every person, so we can use that as a gender determination tool. In females, there are higher number of curved rugae than the males, and higher number of backwards rugae in the females. And for the male, perpendicular rugae's are more than the females. And by kelioscopy, with the lip prints, we can do the sex determination, as the each lip print is different. There are classification given by Suzuki. There are five types of lip prints are there, and mostly the one and two is for the females, and three, four, and five is for the male gender determination. And in molecular analysis, with all this analysis, molecular analysis gives in assistant with all these methods, it gives accurate results. And like bar bodies and F bodies, which is present in the pulp, it gives accurate result after, because the tooth pulp does not change till the 1 year. The tissues remains for the diagnostic purpose, and we can use the Y chromosome, fluorescent Y chromosome test for male patients. And even sex determination can be done with the polymerase chain reaction, in that PCR, real-time PCR, nested PCRs can be used, which also helps gives an accurate result. And enamel proteins also can be used, and labeled processes. Sometimes some processes has name, patient name, and phone number or address, so we can do the identify the a person by the labeled processes. Next slide. So with using all these methods, a forensic odontologist can help to identify the sex and determine sex determination in the forensic science, when the body is decomposed, or any when only the parts of the body is available, when the teeth, only the teeth available, or the skull available. That time we can use all these methods, and thus the forensic odontologist can help in gender determination. Thank you, sir.